Introducing Airborne Aircraft Carriers, where the sky meets strategy and innovation soars. Elevating naval power, these giants blend aviation with maritime might. During the 1920s, the United States was at the forefront of aircraft carrier development. The only dedicated examples to have been built were airships, although existing heavier-than-air aircraft have been modified for use in similar roles, and airborne aircraft carriers of various types appear in fiction, such as Cloudbase, in Gerry Anderson's Captain Scarlet, and the Mysterians, the Valiant from Series 3 of Doctor Who, and an unnamed one in Sky Captain and the World of Tomorrow. In theory, the idea of an airborne carrier appears ideal, an aircraft carrier that traverses both land and water, transforming into a floating base in the skies. Nonetheless, the practicality of creating such a weapon platform appears remote. Several factors contribute to this improbability. Firstly, the sheer magnitude of constructing such a colossal craft raises financial concerns. The endeavor would demand resources on a scale that could challenge even a small nation's budgetary capacities. Moreover, to embark on such a venture, a specialized construction facility would need to be established expressly for this intricate project. Secondly, the technological requirements to sustain such an aerial behemoth appear to be entrenched in the realm of fiction rather than reality. The technicalities of maintaining buoyancy for a flying carrier, akin to that of a maritime vessel, remain a substantial obstacle. Given these complex challenges, the concept of a flying aircraft carrier, while theoretically appealing, encounters significant hurdles. The intricacies of financing, specialized construction, and the technological leaps necessary to support its airborne existence collectively present formidable barriers. The U.S. Navy was the first to pioneer the concept of a flying carrier, and it began construction of two rigid airships, the USS Macon and the USS Akron, in the late 1920s. Neither of these airships had a runway, but instead each carried five lightweight Curtiss F-9C Sparrowhawk biplane fighters that could be launched and recovered through a hook system that lowered them into the airstream. Current long-range bombers possess the capability to access any location worldwide. However, the concept of a flying aircraft carrier introduces concerns. Such an airborne platform could become susceptible as a mobile target, unlike naval aircraft carriers, which benefit from protection by destroyers and submarines. An airborne counterpart would require accompanying defensive craft to ensure effective safeguarding. It's essential to note that the security mechanisms in place for aircraft carriers at sea might not directly translate to an airborne scenario. To achieve suitable protection for a flying aircraft carrier, a comparable fleet of defensive aircraft or supporting vessels would need to be developed and incorporated into its operation. While long-range bombers already have extensive reach, adapting the concept of a flying aircraft carrier requires careful consideration of the logistical and defensive challenges posed by the aerial environment. A more practical approach has been developed by the defense contractor Dynetics in collaboration with DARPA's support. The X-61A Gremlin air vehicle is an innovative. Unmanned drone developed under the Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency's DARPA, Gremlins program. This program aims to create a new class of reusable drones that can be launched and recovered from larger aircraft, such as the C-130 Hercules. A remarkable historical example involves a modified aircraft known as the B-36 Peacemaker. Initially designed as a conventional bomber during World War II, it was notably larger than even the enduring B-52 Stratofortress, which remains in operation today. Despite its extensive development, this bomber never undertook any operational missions. However, it was deliberated for potential use as an airborne aircraft carrier. In this conceptualization, the bomber would carry several Republic YRF-84F FICON parasitic fighters within its vast payload bay. These fighters could be securely attached to and launched from the bomber. This launching and retrieval process would be facilitated by an extendable mechanism located beneath the bomber's fuselage. The viability of this idea was eventually diminished by the advancement of mid-air refueling technology. Another notable concept in the realm of airborne aircraft carriers was embodied by the Lockheed CL-1201. This ambitious proposal featured a colossal nuclear-powered aircraft characterized by its impressive specifications, a weight of 5,265 tons, a wingspan stretching 120 feet, 340 meters, and a fuselage spanning 560 feet, 170 meters. The aircraft's endurance was remarkable, potentially remaining airborne for nearly 6 weeks. Its intended operational capacity encompassed a crew of approximately 850 individuals, along with the theoretical accommodation of over 20 multi-role fighters, affixed to docking pylons situated on its expansive wings. Additionally, the proposal incorporated provisions for a compact internal hangar designed to facilitate repair and maintenance activities. Regrettably, this visionary concept never transcended the stage of theoretical design and did not progress beyond initial planning and discussion. With that said, thank you for watching. Be sure to hit that subscribe button and stay tuned for more.